Welcome back. Small decor projects can give your home a fresh look without breaking the budget. And today, all you need is spray paint, gloves, and eyewear.
Just ignore the sound of the screaming child down the street.
Here to show us what to do, Etsy trend expert Dana Isom Johnson. Great to have you, Dana.
Dana, how come your jumpsuit looks so cute?
I work for Etsy.
You and think these are very cute, Kelly.
We look like we've escaped from prison.
Great.
It gives us edge.
Yeah.
All right. What's the first thing people should get? Are you okay? What's the first thing people should consider when freshening up their home?
Well, first things first is safety, right? Because whenever you're working with spray paint, you gotta be in fresh air. You don't want to breathe that in. You gotta protect the manis. Keep your gloves on, and then eyewear, right? So then, after you do all the safety tips first, the first thing to keep in mind is that you don't have to break the bank. You can repurpose, reuse, refresh. Okay. That's what we're gonna do
today. Let's get started.
All right, so when working with spray paint, also the number one thing to remember, shake them up, shake them up, shake them up, shake them, okay?
Shake them up, shake them up, shake them up, shake them.
Wrong one, though. Let's start with the sea glass. That's okay.
Shake the right one, shake the right one, shake the right one.
So, the first technique I'm going to show you guys is all about sea glass paint. So, if you can see, I have a few done. We're all craving the beach a little right now, right?
Yes, we are, yes.
So, the wonderful thing about this is that it's super easy. You don't have to go to the beach and have, you know, search the beach for forever. So, the other tip that I have is always keep yourself a little piece of cardboard here so you can test the paint.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So, let's test the paint first. On your, here.
Mine looks like water.
I'll stay here. There you go. Yep, that's okay.
That's all right.
Because the good thing about, got the marble though. We're not moving on to marble.
You put hair
yet.
On there.
I've got a sea glass for you down there.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Stop getting
that's
in trouble.
Okay.
Etsy will never have you back.
You're just, you're just jumping ahead.
We're just shaking. Okay. We're still shaking.
So we're shaking and you grab yourself one of those clear glasses
here,
down there.
Have some.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And then you're just gonna aim away. And go to town with
Which way's
it.
Away? Sorry.
That works. That's away. So what I love about this sea glass spray paint is that it comes in a lot of different tones of blue. So you can put it all together and you let it dry.
You should be able to see through it a little bit.
Exactly. Right? Yep. Because it should look like it's tumbled through the sea.
Okay. Great.
All right. So we're going to move on to another texturized type of spray paint, which is marble paint. This
is
really wonderful because it transforms regular surfaces into something that looks like marble. So you see the finished product that we have right there?
Yeah.
It's also really awesome because you can get this in stone and marble, and you can completely transform
the
surface.
Are we doing on the green here or the blue, whatever
you
color?
You can do a green, and Kelly, you can do the black.
Okay. I'm afraid. Oh, that's really cool.
See, isn't that great?
And so this is
this
is the green.
That's cool.
Right? The marble.
Yeah. Here, you know that one?
Hunter green?
Oh, nope. You want to get another marble one. So
can
you can
I use
take
your...
Ryan's marble.
Mine's black.
May I borrow your marble?
Sure.
I'm gonna marble this.
Yep, you can marble it.
There you go.
So
that's
it has this really great effect.
Look at that.
Oh, look at you. Marble and glass on top of the seafoam.
Very
like
soft trigger finger. Well done.
But that's the great thing about crafting, right?
What's
so we're
next?
gonna move on to doorknobs and handles here.
Okay.
Now what I really love about this is that again, you're not breaking the bank. You don't have to go and buy new.
Right.
Just take a look at your doorknobs, your kitchen cabinets. Spray paint is less than $10 and you can refresh it. So that one is the green. I already did one with this green that I really, really love.
It's very cool.
It just adds some personality to it. So, go to town. That's a metallic there.
Oh, I love it.
Oh, that's cool. I like the
really
color
great.
Of that.
You let that dry before you hit it again with the second layer.
Two coats.
Two coats, exactly.
How long does it take to dry about?
Oh, an hour, maybe.
Okay, got it.
Yeah, but listen, like, adding these metallics and adding these marble effects is really a great way to add that luxe. Mm-hmm. On Etsy, we saw 60% increases in search for marble. Everyone wants that luxe effect, right?
Yep.
Finally, what I really love, we all have these little magnets around on our kitchen,
refrigerator,
right?
Mm-hmm.
But they're a little kiddie. Yep. So to make these a bit more sophisticated, hit them with a little metallic spray paint, and then you've got an instant chic up for your refrigerator.
I love this so much. It's very cool. It's a great way to repurpose all those letters.
Not breaking the bank and adding some luxe.
You know who keeps, it's Ryan that keeps spraying me, by the way.
Well, I don't know which way the nozzle.
Oh no! Don't spray in your face.
Which way is the nozzle? There we go. Okay, got it. All right, I tell you what, now that we've mastered the can, we've got more right after this. Stay with us. Look at that.
We're back with Etsy trend expert Dana Isom Johnson.
Let's get into floor mats. So what I really love about your doormat is that it is your opportunity to welcome people into your home. So you want to add that touch of personalization.
A little spirit.
Yeah, and you don't have to have a brand new one. You can revive the old one. Let it dry for a second, Ryan.
Okay, you got it.
But you want to go low and slow, exactly what Kelly is doing. Doormats are super popular, 40% increase in searches on Etsy. People are searching for these. Stencils are your best friend because
it
really
keeps it neat, clean. Anybody can
clean.
Do it.
Exactly.
I've proven that.
I feel like there's so many stencils.
We're
going
to let that hang out for a little bit, and then we'll do a reveal.
Okay,
next. Kelly, I love it. You're so committed to it.
I want to finish I can't start something.
I love that. I love it. And if you want to take it over the top even more, you can get personalized stencils to get some funky artwork made.
So now we have Kelly's address, everybody. All right.
All right, so now.
Yes, feel free to show up at 82 Park Street.
So we're gonna move on to mailbox. So you can be the coolest block on the house.
Yeah.
Personalize it. These things, they get weathered by the sun, by, you know, the weather, the elements, all of that. So give it a fresh coat of spray paint, and again, add a little stencil if you guys want. So
very
on one side, there's a flower. Kelly, you can do the flower or the number. It's two sides
Ryan
to it.
Ryan seems to really want to do that.
He said, okay, all right.
Is it cocaine to have a black flower like that? Or do you want a red color?
There's a green right there. You can redo the green if you want.
Let's have a spring flower. Oh, this is the nozzle that's complicated.
That's the sea glass.
So why don't you do it?
I'll do sea glass.
And remember, just low and slow. And then you want everything to dry before adding that second coat, because otherwise it'll get runny.
It seems like it could get very runny. So the sea glass is not going to be the next one.
Because the solution is more part water, part paint.
Exactly.
So the ratio is a little off.
You could try to do the green or the black. We're going to have an ombre effect.
Yeah,
that works too.
We'll see what
That totally works.
We'll see what we get.
Yeah.
Okay,
all right.
Good.
So we're going to let that dry. Then the final piece that is my personal favorite here, if you have a kitchen chair or an outdoor chair that is, again, gotten beat up by the sun, or you're just sick of it and you want to revive it, painter's tape and spray paint. So these are just plastic chairs here, and if you want to do like a little dimension with it, you can add the painter's tape and then you spray paint over
that. Do you want to hold it and I'll spray it?
No, you hold it.
Here, put it down.
So just give it one little quick hit, and then we're going to do a reveal.
So you want me to quick hit it here?
If you want, sure.
Yeah,
I already pre-painted that, but you can just hit it again. That's okay.
Give it like a little.
So it's basically we can peel off the paper.
You can peel it off, but you know what, Kelly? You really like spray painting, and I love that. So we're just going to rock with it.
Some green accent.
We're going to rock with it.
Okay.
You ready?
So
let's reveal it.
Let's do a reveal here. And you just take your tape off, and then you see
that
it can be a really cool chair. Now, the most important thing to keep in mind with all of these projects is that after you have done your spray paint, you want to hit it with a primer so that the paint stays intact and that it's not getting damaged.
All the work sticks.
After.
And again, I always would think primer before, but primer goes after.
Primer before and after.
Before and after.
Because you're going to get a sealer. So
it's great to have you, Dana. Thanks so much for all the fun.
Thank you so much.
For more information, go to kellyandryan.com, and we will be right back here on Live.